Pisces, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Today we doing I hope I ain't do y'all video already, Pisces. I don't think I did. Today we doing what's coming towards you in the next 2 days. So we gonna see what's gonna be happening for you in the next 2 days. What's coming towards you, what you need to know about. Pisces needs to know about for the next 2 days. Money, baby. Y'all making money in the next 2 days, or you getting a check in the next 2 days. Some of y'all could have been anticipating that. You've been wanting something to give you some type of happiness. Y'all looking for some change in your life. Some of y'all want to spend more time with family. You want things to change with that. You really miss being around like the older people in your family. You really miss like that closeness, that bond. You could have family coming towards you in the next 2 days. You may get to spend a lot of time with like the older people in your family. And it may make you feel really good. You just got paid. Friday night. No, it's gonna be what? What's today? Wednesday? Friday night. Like I said, just got paid. It's gonna be Friday night and you're gonna be chilling with your peoples. Sound like a night to remember to me. Some of y'all could be needing to get out the house. You may sleep a lot. You may find yourself in the bed a lot. You may not be wanting to go anywhere. People may have to literally drag you out the house. Some of y'all could be pregnant. And you just really want somebody to talk to. But you want it to be the person that you're in a relationship with. Or you want it to be the person that you're investing into. Even if you're not in a relationship, you just could be dating somebody. Some of y'all could have been dating somebody for 7 months or in a relationship with somebody for 7 months. Ooh, 7 weeks. Some of y'all could be 7 weeks pregnant, 8 months, 7 months, or four. For some of you, you feel cheated out of a business deal. You feel cheated out of some money. But for others of y'all, you just want to invest. You want to talk to the person that you in a relationship with or was dealing with. But you could feel like this person stepped out on you or they don't be around you enough. Some of y'all feel like this person cheated on you and you just really don't want to be around them right now. But you still want it to work out at the same time. And you still want this person to be successful. You don't have no ill feelings towards them. You just want to be single right now. You already know what's up. This person already told you what they did. And you just know at this point in time, you don't want to work on it. Because you feel like it's more shit that they lying about. Or it's more that you need to figure out before you can honestly trust this person. It's like, maybe I need to get more of the scoop. Or it's more to the story. I feel like they leaving some details out. But you tired of trying to figure out what those details are. A lot of y'all are over this situation. You over this person. And it's like, at this point, I don't got no more fight left in me. I don't know what you're doing. I just don't care. I don't care, though. This could be another water sign. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Mm-hmm. y'all left this person and it was hard for you to leave this person. You really wanted to stay with this person. You still wanted to be with them, but you found out they had more than one person the moment y'all got back together. And it's like, you know what? At this point, I never trust you again because we just rekindled things and this is a wrap now. This could be a same-sex connection for some of y'all, relationship, or some of y'all, this is somebody going through this around you. Honestly, could be a family member. Or could be a family member or an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. If this is not your story, place yourself on whatever side of that you want. Somebody was dealing with a lot of people. Yeah, you, like, you didn't just take your offer back. You snatched that shit back and you ran. Give me my heart back, bitch. Give me my keys back. Give me my love back. You took everything you own, everything you bought back from this person, and you like, no, never again. Never, ever, ever, ever again in life would I ever. This person could have also went back to like an ex, somebody that they was married to in the past or in a relationship with in the past. And they didn't think that this would cause any conflict. They didn't think that this would cause any problems. Who is this Queen of Wands to this King of Wands? A relationship that they never really got over, that they always been depressed over or had feelings towards still. This is somebody they was married to, living in a household with. They always felt like they was held back in this situation, or they always felt like they never got the chance to fix it or repair it. This could also be and this person cheated on them. This person cheated on them. They found out this person had somebody else, and that was what really caused like the divorce or the separation. And they didn't have any kids with this person, so it was kind of easy for them to part ways. It was kind of easy for them to part ways from this person. Or for some of y'all, if they, I don't, for some of y'all, this person actually wasn't the father of a kid. So they didn't really have to, they didn't really have to stay connected to this person. Not really, because a child turned out not to be theirs. But they still felt like that was an open wound or a fresh wound. And they decided to go back to the situation when they should have been blocking this person out of their life. This could be a Libra, Taurus, Gemini, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Water sign dealing with this. This could be somebody. Oh, y'all, I don't know what the hell is. What is this? What is this? What are those? This person want their relationship back. They feel like you, they soulmate, they twin flame. They want their relationship back. Or this is somebody that wants a relationship back. Like I said, it could be happening to you or somebody around you. But I feel like you're in the midst of something. Whatever this is, you're in the midst of it. Where does Pisces come in at with this? Death? You are the one that's going to change something or transform or end something for good. You are the one that's going to put a stop to something. You feel like somebody is not going to let something go. They're going to keep doing something. And you don't understand why. you don't understand why somebody is doing something. You feel like somebody that they're dealing with or somebody that they're connecting to or got a problem with or issue with, it's like this person is giving towards you, they love you, they help you, they very generous. Like, why do you act like this, or why do you want to hurt this person or mistreat them? Y'all looking for answers. Y'all are the person that's gonna make this person wake up, make this person open their eyes and realize like the shit that they really out here doing is fucked up, or somebody out here living foul, doing foul ass shit. And you gonna be that person that's gonna make this person hold the mirror up to their face and see like what's going on in their life and what's reflecting back to them. So y'all are that golden mirror for this person. Mirror, mirror up. What is it? Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the dumbest of them all? No, I'm just playing. Who's the fairest of them all? Y'all could be real, real sarcastic with this person. And you could like, it's like you tell this person what they do that's wrong, but you don't sugar. Ooh, I can't even get it out, y'all. This person want you to they want you or me to they want you to be quiet. Like, if you telling this person, oh yeah, I don't think that was right, you causing problems, you wrong. If you disagree with this person and tell them something that they don't want to hear, they I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear that. You supposed to be agreeing with me. You supposed to be telling me this. You supposed to be telling me that. No, you're supposed to be telling this person the truth. You're supposed to be telling this person the truth. And that's exactly what you're doing. And it's causing this person stress that you're telling them the truth, because you are your reflection. You're reflecting back to them what they've been doing to other people. Either you're doing this to them, or somebody around this is around them that they're dealing with is doing this to them. And it's like, hey, this person ain't got no choice but to face themselves, because they don't have nobody else to blame in the situation but themselves. Because y'all feel like somebody didn't deserve some type of treatment. And you're not shy about speaking up on that. Mirror, mirror on the wall, like, who's the fairest of them all? You are. You gonna tell a person what it is. You gonna tell a person what it is, what it needs to be, like where they went wrong, where they fucked up at. You are not going to hold back or hold your tongue for nobody. You're gonna speak on how you feel down to a T, and you're not gonna let nobody like quiet you when it comes to that. Somebody ain't gonna have no choice but to face they self. Because you're not in the wrong for giving your opinion on or speaking on something that you feel. Talk your shit, boo. No. What Boosie say? Talk your shit, Boosie. Yeah, talk your shit. Some of y'all could be very outspoken like Boosie. Or you could like to state your opinion, and your opinion may get you in trouble a lot, or a lot of people may just always have something to say or roll their eyes when you speak or open your mouth. But hey, people gonna hate the realists. People gonna hate motherfuckers that speak the truth. That don't mean you should stop doing it. Still be that person, okay? Still be that person that's gonna give it to people straight, no chasers. Give it to people just like it is. Thank you. Okay. What else is coming towards Pisces for the next 2 days? Somebody waiting to figure out some evidence. Somebody waiting on somebody to post, waiting on somebody to say something, or they waiting to find some evidence about something. That's what they focused on heavily for the next couple of days. That's their main goal, is to find some evidence about something. Figure out what somebody is doing. Because they feel like somebody doesn't care. They feel like somebody is extremely calm. They too calm. They should be stressed out. What's going on? I don't know what this person is doing. What's imagination? This person is imagining the worst case scenarios right now. They don't know what somebody is doing, and they trying to figure out what this person got going on. They feel like they made the wrong decision by down talking somebody. They want somebody to trust them, and they feel like this person will never trust them. But they want this situation to be stable. Whoever this is, they want to build a stable foundation with someone, and they feel like they cannot do that because they don't treat this person fairly, or they real mean to this person. And they feel like they feel like this person is supposed to tolerate that from them. Or this could be you, that they feel is supposed to tolerate that. Somebody is losing, like, love. Somebody is losing the love of their life. Mary J. Blige, I Love You playing. I don't even know this song. But it's on my shuffle playlist. So, I don't know. It's like somebody is losing the love of their life, basically. They still in love with somebody that they feel like is falling out of love with them. And they still want it to work out. And they just feel like they're taking a huge loss right now. What's this? And they feel like the person that they dealing with is such a mystery. Like, they don't know what this person is doing. It's like, I never know what this person is doing, but I always know that they telling the truth. I always can feel when they telling the truth. So they feel like they can feel when this person is being honest with them. And they also feel like this person, if this is somebody that's into like tarot, or they do tarot readings, they feel like this person tells the truth. Like, they speak the truth when they do their readings, or they speak the truth with what they say. Like, they feel like somebody's intuition is on point. This could even be you that may be the tarot reader, or somebody could be dealing with, you know, somebody that's very intuitive. But they feel like somebody knows what they talking about. They on their shit. That's why I said, talk your shit, Boosie. Or boo, whatever the fuck he said. That's why I said that, because somebody feels that way. It's like, okay, well, I feel like something is legit, and I really just need to apologize. Somebody could have doubted you, or they doubted somebody else. And now they having second thoughts about that, because they really don't want to pull back from this person, or they really don't want this person to go nowhere. They just want some good news. They ready to hear some sort of good news, and this person is playing blind until then. They want to act like they not trying to get this person's attention, since they feel like this person is so focused on themselves. It's like, well, since they not gonna hesitate about loving themselves, let me try to beat them at their own game and act like I'm focusing on me too. What this person is really trying to do is just spend more time with their friends to show this person that they in a relationship with, or competing with, or whatever the fuck may be. They want to show this person that, oh, I'm hanging with my friends, I'm going out, I'm still having fun, I'm not trying to get you back, we ain't over, but I'm not trying to get you back. And what they're going to do is basically go back to a third party. Because this person hasn't learned their lesson yet. They want somebody to be angry. They want somebody to be pissed off. Since somebody won't be with them, they want to piss this person off and continue to deal with a third party in order to stress out this person, or in order to fuck up what somebody does. it's like, since your intuition is on point, now you really gonna catch me when I'm always cheating, or now you really gonna catch me when I'm always trying to hurt you or pulling a fuck move towards you or being a fuck boy or a fuck girl. Now you really finna catch me. They feel like this is the right thing to do since they got so much on their plate and this person is too busy helping other people, being alone, being off to themselves, saving the world. Oh, what the fuck? They feel like somebody is too busy focusing on their life, and they feel like this person does not deserve to have it all. Why do they deserve to have the relationship? Why do they deserve to have the commitment? Why do they? Somebody wants to know why someone is so worthy of everything that they're getting in their life. Why are they the one with the gift? Somebody hates somebody that they're supposed to love, basically. They cannot relax as long as this person is breathing. As long as this person is happy, they cannot relax. So, somebody basically hate the person that they're supposed to love because they see them as competition. They view them as competition. They view them as somebody that they have to destroy, that they have to knock down. If they can't control this person, they feel like this person is controlling them. They're disturbed by this person's spirituality. They feel some type of way because they feel like this person is just supposed to commit to them, be in a relationship with them, and just cry about whatever is going wrong. Or, if this is family, y'all, this could be like a family member that wants another family member to be around them so bad that if they're not willing to hang with this family member, connect with them, then they'll destroy their life. I hate you because I can't be around you. I hate you because I can't be you. I hate you even more because you won't compete with me. And I hate you even more than that because you're a better person than I feel like I am. How can you keep throwing out love when you know motherfuckers hate you? Somebody hates somebody guts. This could be family, or this could be somebody like a love interest doing this to you, or a family member. I don't know, like, what the hell? This just threw me for a loop. What is this? Yeah, this person don't have no desire to be around them because they know exactly what this person is doing to them. They not crazy. They want this person to be stressed out over them, crying tears. They want this person to settle. They want somebody to settle for being like in a two-way relationship, or they want somebody to settle with being okay with being like the other woman or the other man. They want somebody to do that. They want somebody to be in a third party situation. This is somebody wanting somebody to get cheated on or get hurt, get dogged out. Or this is like a love interest wanting somebody to compromise, wanting somebody to settle because they don't want to choose between two people. So they want to force two people to fight, or they want to force one person to compete with the other, and one person is not competing. They done walked away from the whole situation because they feel like, fuck you, fuck the situation, and fuck the competition. Because why would I do that? Why would I do that? And that's the main reason I got these cards. That's dirt. Let me turn him off because he is going to get in my head. Like, I had a lyric in my head that was really fucking me up. Okay? Somebody is not into that shit, and this person is trying to force somebody to be okay with settling, force somebody to be okay with them having them and then having a side person. Or somebody wants to force you to do this, like put yourself on whatever side you on. Somebody wants to force somebody to be okay with, like, look, like, we not gonna get married, we not gonna do this if you won't be okay with me cheating. if you won't be okay with me having a side person, if you won't be okay with me living with you, loving on you, but from time to time I go stop by my other chick house and get a plate of food and do this, or my other man house and get a plate of food and do this, bitch, you, them side people and all them can go to hell. That's what y'all gotta tell them. All them people can go to hell. Or if this is a family member hurting you or somebody else, go to hell. They need to really stop doing it. That's not cool. But I'm gonna get the advice and then we're gonna close it out. What's the advice for Pisces? Focus on the things that are going to take you to higher levels, the levels that you want to go to. Focus on your art. Some of y'all are very talented. No, a lot of y'all are very talented. You're very creative. It don't matter what you do. You could do hair, but you're very creative with your hands. You could do music, but you're very creative with your voice. Your voice is very unique. You can maybe do poems. You can even be an artist. Maybe you paint. But your paintings be dope. They just got this little signature touch that can't nobody else place their fingers on, or can't nobody else quite get it just right like you. So y'all got this one little ting that other people can't duplicate that shit. You got that ting. Motherfuckers can't duplicate you. Okay, so be you, be authentic, be real, and focus on the things that matter in your life. Don't focus on the negativity. Do not focus on the drama. Always speak your truth. Always speak your peace. Be honest, especially with the people around you, especially if this is involving family, because I see inner child and I see family and I see elders, which tells me for a lot of y'all, this could be something that's going on, like family, hating family or hating on family. Or this could be you going through something where somebody is just not doing right by you and they have a family with you. Okay? So, yeah. Like I said, use your voice. You got a new life coming and don't let nothing pull you back to where you were. That's all I got for y'all, though. Thank you for watching, Pisces. Don't forget to hit the like button, share, and subscribe. Bye, y'all.